This video is on rotational kinetic energy. We recall the equation for translational kinetic energy is 1/2 mv squared. For rotation, it's a similar looking equation, 1/2 I omega squared. The rotational analog of mass is moment of inertia. The rotational analog of v is omega. So that's pretty neat. Via units show that the energies above are equivalent. On the right side here, we've got kilograms, and then we've got meters squared over seconds squared. What about over here? We remember that the unit for a moment of inertia is kilogram meters squared. And then for omega, that would be radians per second. So we'd have radians squared per second squared. Well, here's the thing. A radian is a unitless unit. A radian is kind of a nothing. And so what we end up with is kilogram meters squared per second squared for both cases. What that means is these two energies are additive. You can add them up and get a single answer. If an object is translating only, its kinetic energy is found via the equation 1/2 mv squared. If it's rotating only, that is, if the axis is not moving, then we need to use 1/2 I omega squared. If it's rolling without slipping, then its kinetic energy is going to be the sum of these. So anytime we have rolling without slipping, both of those pieces of the puzzle need to be in there. We combine those two parts by using the bridge equation between the velocities, which is v is r omega. That's how we can effectively make these two quantities talk to each other for a given problem. And tabulated formulas for the moments of inertia. We've talked in the past about how moments of inertia are often tabularized. And they're always of the form, they have some constant, and then mr squared. So it depends if it's a solid sphere, a hollow sphere, a hoop, a solid cylinder, or whatever. But it's always going to be some fraction multiplied by mr squared. Let's try one example problem where we're going to conserve energy and see both kinetic energies come into play, kinetic energy of translation as well as rotation. So we have a disk here at the top, and it's rolling down, and we want to know what its speed is at the end. Let's conserve mechanical energy. The mechanical energy at the top is the mass of this thing multiplied by g, multiplied by how high it is, which is h. The energy at the end, there's no gravitational potential energy, but we do have translational kinetic energy. I'm not going to write vcom, I'm just going to write v. Plus rotational kinetic energy, 1/2 I omega squared. Now that looks like a lot of variables there, and it is. And we need to find one expression for the speed. This v is what we need to find here. Let's combine these using a little bit of thinking. The moment of inertia of a solid disk, you could look up. You've been watching these videos, we've been talking about this several times already. The moment of inertia of a solid disk is 1/2 mr squared. That gives us m's for both of these terms. Now, what about v's? Well, we just said that the bridge equation between velocities is v is equal to omega multiplied by r. So that means that omega is equal to v divided by r. And then I've squared both of those because it's omega squared. Now that really helps us out because you see we have r squared in the denominator right there, and we have r squared in the numerator right there, which leaves us with what? I'm seeing 1/2 mv squared, and what's this going to be? 1/4 mv squared. So won't that be a total of 3/4 mv squared. So let's set those equal to each other. Here we go. mgh equals 3/4 mv squared. The m's cancel. Put the 4 there, the 3 there. Let's solve for the speed of this thing. I think we're going to get 4/3 gh square rooted.